If you think the price of winning is too high, wait until you get the bill for regret. That was a quote I heard from Tim Grover, the author of this book Relentless, which showed me that winning is not just an accident, but instead the result of going to war against yourself daily.
All winners have lost.
Winners fail a million times.
From reading Relentless,
what makes them a winner is that they believe in it, they're headstrong.
I know I don't believe winning is just about finishing in first place, but I think it's about who it allows you to become in the process.
All winners have been disappointed and confused and frustrated and angry.
I think winning means to overcome your excuses, your limitations, and your fears.
But they kept moving forward.
I believe it's about conquering yourself daily with the hopes of turning your dreams into reality.
What makes one guy a champion and the other one not?
It's drive, it's the will.
Because I've realized we've all been looking at things wrong the whole time.
There's certain people that grow up with a tremendous hunger to be the best in the world.
Our competition has never actually been with anyone else. Our true competition has only ever been our bad habits, our procrastination, our lack of discipline, our fear, and our self-doubt. And once you can consistently compete against that, that's when you ultimately just make it so hard for yourself to lose that it becomes easy to win. Take Michael Jordan, one of the greatest competitors of our time. In this old interview of his I recently seen, the reporter asks him, "Who's your biggest competitor?" He pauses for a second and says, "Myself." And see, that's the mentality of a cleaner. What's a cleaner, you ask? Well, in Relentless, Tim Grover says, cleaners are the most intense and driven competitors imaginable. They are people who refuse to place limitations on themselves and are in a constant pursuit of excellence. They're always believing in their ability and always demanding more of themselves than anyone else. And that's the mentality I'm trying to develop, because I think if we really want to achieve our goals and develop a relentless drive to push ourselves daily, we need to develop this mentality. And one of the ways you can do that is to start running directly at fear, because you cannot win unless you face your fears. Like, I'm gonna be honest, these last 2 months, I felt the fear to upload a video. And that's because a lot of people from where I'm from found my channel. And I wouldn't say I felt embarrassed or anything, because I really like the content I create. But the thing is, I weirdly started overthinking what I was saying in my videos, because my mind started to play tricks on me by making me think these people are going to laugh at me for sharing my ideas. But then it hit me. Everyone who's ever went out and achieved something meaningful in their lives has had to face some form of fear, because success requires you to leave your comfort zone, which is going to always produce some form of fear. And see, that's the thing that stops most people from attacking their goals. They're scared of having to face their fears. They're scared to have to overcome the opinions of others. But the thing I learned about winners is that they don't let their fears hold them back, but instead use them as a way to grow. And during that situation, I realized we all have the ability to overcome fear. And a way I found you can do that is to just change your perception of fear. Instead of resenting it, you can decide to view it as an opportunity to grow. Take hitting a hard leg day in the gym, studying for a hard exam, or having a hard conversation with someone. I know in the past, these sort of things would cause me to feel so anxious. My brain would think of all the things that could go wrong, and I'd start thinking about how difficult this situation is going to be. But then when I would finally decide to do it, I would always end up thinking, why was I holding myself back all this time? It wasn't even that bad. And when you face these things, don't you find you gain this confident-like buzz where you just want to attack more hard tasks? And look, thankfully to short form, I was able to learn the key points of these mindset books in just a few hours. See, short form gives you full guides to pretty much any book in any genre you could want, including the most popular books in genres like money and finance, business, and productivity. For example, I read The Guide to the Mountain Is You by Brianna West, which showed me that as humans, we self-sabotage when we desire a change in our lives but are too scared to act. And the guide explained how this internal conflict creates a barrier between who you are and who you want to be. And after reading this guide, Shortform even gave me some exercises to help me apply the information. So if you want the chance to get access to new book guides and articles every week, where subscribers can even vote to get a book covered. Just click on my unique link at the top of the description, which will grant you access to a free short form trial and a discount on your membership. Anyway, in Relentless, Tim Grover mentions that if you want to be a cleaner and develop a winning mentality, you need to develop self-control. Why is that important? Well, Alex Hormozi said, when he was studying the serial winners in every career field, he noticed that the one trait they all shared in common was they had impulse control, meaning they all had the trained ability to fight the urge to do things that would hurt them in the long run. They had the ability to resist any temptation and just stay focused on their tasks. See, impulse control is just another form of self-control, and I found the way you build self-control is by training your willpower. And in Relentless, Tim Grover basically says you train your willpower by challenging yourself every day to do something hard. He says every day challenge yourself to be uncomfortable, push past the apathy, laziness, and fear. He says if you don't do the hard things you know you need to do, you can't improve. Because similarly to discipline, self-control is like a trainable muscle, meaning the more you implement self-control in your life, the stronger your self-control ultimately becomes. Because he says, bottom line, if you want success of any kind, you have to be comfortable being uncomfortable. And he also mentions that to be a cleaner, you have to fall in love with failure. See, what's so fascinating about failure is that it's a paradox. As Michael Jordan famously said, to win, you gotta lose. To be successful, you gotta have something that's not successful. To be happy, you gotta have disappointment. See, that's the clear difference between the average person and a cleaner. What most people see as a failure, a cleaner sees as an opportunity, because they're doing something everyone else sees as impossible. And the thing is, most people aren't willing to put themselves in the position to fail, so they ultimately never stand the chance of becoming the successful version of themselves they wish they could be, because they would rather stay in the comfort zone where there's no risk and it's safe. Like in Relentless, it poses a question that really makes you think. Tim Grover says, people refuse to work out and control their diets because it's not comfortable for them. Explain to me, if you can choose between being uncomfortable because you're overweight and sick, or uncomfortable because you're sweating at the gym 3 times a week, why do so many people choose the discomfort that leads to complete physical failure? And yeah, I get that might sound harsh, but it really just shows you that we get to choose our hard. Because I think, if you're going to feel discomfort either way, why not just feel the discomfort to become the person you really want to be in life? And by no means am I saying it's easy to feel. I know firsthand that it can be so demoralizing. But from my perspective, I believe if you try as hard as you can at something and don't give up, eventually things have to work out for you in one way or another. Because if energy cannot be created or destroyed, only transferred, doesn't that mean that all that energy and hard work you're putting in has to eventually lead to some form of outcome? Because personally, I believe you can only throw dirt at a wall for so long until eventually something sticks. And I learned that firsthand from making these videos. For 3.5 years, I spent ages creating videos just for them to barely scrape 100 views. And that's why I understand that failure can be so demoralizing. But the thing is, when I really started to give my best, that's when my videos started to take off. Because I believe it's pretty simple. The more energy you put in, the more you get out. And obviously, I gotta thank God for all the success he's brought me over the last year. And look, I've ultimately came to the realization that winners are just obsessed. They're obsessed with getting better and obsessed with improving. And from reading Relentless, I've learned that cleaners are able to achieve their most ambitious goals because they have a strong why. What I mean by a strong why is that they have a clear reason for why they do what they do. As Nietzsche said, he who has a way to live for can bear almost any how. And see, if you don't have a strong way, you're always going to fall for the temptation to quit and take the easier option when things get hard. So figure out why you want to be successful, because it's your way that pushes you to keep going when your body is telling you you should quit and give up. And not only do the most highly successful people all have strong ways, but they also have clear goals. They all know exactly what direction they're going in. Because how are we meant to become successful if we don't have clear goals. Like Earl Nightingale said, without a goal, we are as much like the man with a boat and nowhere to go. Goals give us the drive and energy we need to remain on track long enough for their accomplishment. So give yourself some time away from technology and distractions and just ask yourself some questions. Like, what am I passionate about? What do I feel I could really give my best at? What makes me feel truly alive where I don't even notice the time passing? And look, finding what you want to do with your life isn't easy. Some people never find it. But it's better to at least try to think about, what do I really want to do with my life, instead of just sitting there and letting it drift by. And honestly, I feel like deep down we all know exactly what we want to do in our lives. I feel like most of us have just lost touch with what that is because we've ended up suppressing it for so long out of our fear and insecurities. But see, that's the thing with winners. They attack their true goals. They break through them self-made walls of doubt, limitation, and fear because they eventually realize it's better to live a life trying to achieve their real ambitions than always having to sit around and wonder what could have been if they had have really attacked their goals. As Greg Plitt said, it's hard to get up and try, but it's 10 times harder to have to look back with regret. I can tell you the worst failure in life isn't the person that fell down, it's the person that never got up and tried. So brother, enjoy the process of becoming better, and as cringe as it may sound, go out there and feel, and go out there and truly become the person you want to be. As always, make sure to subscribe and leave a comment down below on how you've been trying to upgrade your mentality. As always, through hard work we grow. Peace.